Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creating Process. In this video, we'll be looking at how you can apply dual lighting effect to an image. I'll be using this portrait image and show you how you can apply these effects in very simple steps. So first of all, I'll be showing you the steps to create out these design, and after that I'll be working on a small project where I'll show you how you can use those techniques and apply it to create your own graphic design. So let's begin with the designing process. So first of all, let's open our image. So if you have an image, just open it in Photoshop like this. So open it in Photoshop and here is our image. So once your image is imported, the first thing you're gonna do is to edit it if it's not clear. So right now I think my image looks fine, but if your image is quite dull or is quite very bright, you have to adjust the brightness. So use the curve tool and just make it darker if it's bright, or make it brighter if it's dark. But for now, I think this is good. The first thing we're gonna do is to add a gradient adjustment layer on top. So select the layer and go over here, effects, and click on gradient. And this will add a gradient adjustment layer on top. Over here, the color is black gradient color and the angle is 90 degrees. As you can see, it's coming from bottom. So for now, the first thing we're gonna do is to change the angle to left side. So I'll just put 0 degree angle and the colors come from left side, and then let's change the color. So I'll just click on this, click on the color, and let's choose blue color. So I'll just pick this deep blue color like that and click OK. And on the next side here, I'll just delete out this slider because I'll be using only one of this color. And now I'll just adjust the color gradient slider. So I'll keep it from the middle to this side. So here, I'll just keep it around here and just drag this slider on the right side and just extend it until you see over here it crosses that middle region, and use the middle small slider to adjust the movement of the color like that. Now for now I think it's fine. I'll just click OK and then OK. So next, change the blend mode to color. So change the color to blend mode to color, and this will give you this harsh color. So we'll just reduce the opacity and it will be balanced, but as you can see, it has applied over here. Now let's reduce the opacity around, let's reduce it to around 60%. Let's look at it. That's good. I think this is fine. Now let's create a duplicate of this gradient adjustment layer and double click on this to open this attribute. Over here, for now, let's change the angle to 180 degree. This will bring out the color from the right hand side. So I'll just type a 180 degree, and as you can see, it's coming from this side. Let's change the color. I'll just go over here, click on the color, and for now, let's apply red color. So I'm taking some dark red color over here and then click OK. Now let's adjust the slider to change the position of the color. So for now, as you can see, the color is crossing the middle region. So I'll just bring back the color and then I'll just shift to this side. I'm just trying to blend the color blue and red and using this, and then click OK. So we have added that red and blue blend over here. So next step we have to do is to just select these two layers and create a duplicate like that. And selecting these two, let's change the blend mode to soft light. So this will add this soft color around the surrounding as well as on the image. Let's reduce the opacity for this around 40%, or around 35 or 40 as per your needs. So right now I feel the color combination is good. So over here I think this is good, but I'll just keep it around 60 because I feel that's give you more natural look to the image. Now the next thing we're gonna do is to adjust the contrast, like brightness and stuff. So I'll add brightness and contrast adjustment layer first, and let's reduce the contrast like that. It will give you that little blend, and let's increase the brightness of the image. So you can see now more details over here. I'll keep it around 40. Now let's do a little more adjustment, last step. So I'll add one more, that's curve adjustment layer. So if you want to increase the glossiness, use this and just bring it on the left side. And to increase the contrast, as you can see, overall image is getting brighter. I'll just click over here and just drag it down a little bit and it will maintain that depth. So as you can see, this increases the brightness and this will maintain that depth. So I think this looks really good. So finally, this is how you can apply dual lighting effect to an image. But if you want to go more further step, like you want to add some special effect to your image, like if you see over here, I have added some cloud effect in the background, and surrounding you can see some particle effects. So to do that, it's very simple. So to add a cloud, the first thing we're gonna do is to add a layer on top of the background layer. So add a new layer, fill it up with dark color, alt backspace. I have applied black color, and now I'll apply some effects. So I'll go to filter, render, and clouds, and this will add a cloud to this layer. So now let's change the blend mode to yes, overlay is fine. So this has totally blended with the background. Let's reduce the opacity. So I'll just reduce the fill value around 10. Now, as you can see, the whole cloud effect is applied to the image. So I need to apply it on the background only. So let's mask out the region. Let's apply a mask to this layer. And let's, for now, let's increase the opacity and select the brush tool, brush. And as you can see over here, it's white and black. So if I switch to black, you can just paint it over here and you can remove those clouds from the image. And if I change it to white, it will again apply it back, like it's minus brush and eraser. So just choose black. With the X, you can switch the color. So selecting the black, I'm just painting it all over the region where I don't want to apply the cloud effects. So the original image is preserved. Now if I reduce the opacity around 9 or 10, you can see that effect in the background. Next, let's apply that particle effect. So I got a particle image here. I'll just drag and drop it over here, and it is here. Now let's scale up the size and let's rotate the angle. Enter. And here is our image. I'll just change the blend mode to screen. You can apply screen or either lighter. So as you if you apply screen, you can see the whole image become brighter. I don't need that effect. I need only the particle effect. So I'm choosing the lighter version, and as you can see, it shows only the particles. Now the next step is very simple. You can use the same steps, like apply a mask to it and use the brush tool and just erase out the extra particles from the scene to give that effect to our image. So here we go, here is our image. So finally we have created this dual lighting effect. Now let's look at an example on how you can use this technique to create out a cover or a graphic design. So here is our example. I have used this technique to create out this design. So let's create this out. And so for that, let's open a new document. Let's keep the size to like this. So create it out, and here is our file. So first thing, let's bring in our image. So here is our image. I'll just open this in Photoshop and let's remove the background. So for this example, I'm using this image with a light background. So it's always advisable that if you're using image for these kinds of projects, just make sure that you're choosing an image which has lighter background, so you can remove the background very easily. So let me show you how you can remove these background in very few steps. So selecting this image, go to select color range, and over here it's already so cleanly selected. If it's not, just use the eyedropper tool like this and just click on the background like this. With a shift pressed, it will add, and with the alt pressed, it will subtract like that. So once you are happy with these overall, just click OK and it will make a selection like this. And now let's apply mask and Command or Control I to inverse the selection. With the alt press, just click on this thumbnail of the mask. You can see this. So use the brush tool and just fill up the empty spaces. Okay, so once you are happy with the selection, just click on this alt and click, and it will again come out. Now as you can see, the edges are very edgy. So I'll just double click on this and increase the radius a little bit and increase the smoothness like that. So, and you can do some edge shift over here. If you feel like you want to hide these extra region from the outside, just shift this little inward and it will hide out all these things, and then click OK. So here is our image. Now let's just drag and drop it. So I'll just click and drag and drop it to our file. Let's convert this into smart object, scale up the size and place it around here in the center. Now let's apply the effect. So it's very simple, follow those same steps. So first of all, let's flip the image. So I'll go to image rotation and flip canvas horizontally like this. So you can easily flip the canvas. Now let's apply the gradient. So gradient adjustment layer here, choose the magenta color. So here we go like that and then click OK. Let's remove this color and let's bring it around here. Let's shift the position like this. Let's change the angle over here, keep it to 0. Let's bring this color around half region of the image. So I'm just bringing it around here, and we'll be using this to balance the color range like this. So I'll change the blend mode to color now. And now let's duplicate another one, double click on it, change the angle to 180 degree, and let's change the color to little bluish green. So I'll just choose choosing the color that I feel like good. And now once you're done with this, let's click OK. So here we go. After this, let's select these two layers and just reduce the opacity around 60. This will give you that natural lighting effect. And let's duplicate this layer and change the blend mode to soft light and reduce the opacity around, let's say, 50. So I'll just keep it around 50 like this. And let's add a curve. And you can just do some adjustment with the curve a little bit to add a contrast. Keep it like this. And now let's add a text. So I'll just type out text. So if I see over here, the font I have used is this awesome South Korean. So I'm using this font, paste it over here and enter. Here we go. And let's apply gradient color to this. So it's very simple to apply gradient color to the text. So just double click on it, gradient overlay, and just choose the color. So just choose dual color and then pick this color for this. For the other side, let's pick some blue color like that, like this, and then click OK. So here you go. So as you can see, the effects are applying to every element that's on the background. So select all these and just clip it to this layer. So just with the alt press, just clip everything to this single layer, and here we go. Our text has got its own gradient colors like that. So I'll just double click on it and let's just make the magenta color a little bit dull so that you can give that you can get that nice effect. And we'll add a few more text tutorials. So here is our text. Let's select these three and I'll just change the color to something darker tone and select all these three layers and just align them like this. Now after that, let's add a background. So for that background gradient, I just double click on this and let's add a gradient color. So gradient overlay and let's pick a color. So I'll just pick some random color from here, make it a little brighter like this and then click OK. For the second region, let's pick some this color. Let's make it a little brighter and click OK. So this way. And after that, let's change the angle a little bit. So this way we have applied. Let's add some effect as well with the pan tool. I'll just draw some curves to give some variation in design like this. Apply gradient overlay and we'll change the blend mode overlay. So you can give some nice cool effect if you want to. Just make sure that they are nicely blend, reduce the opacity a bit, okay, and reduce the fill value a little bit, like to give that nice blend in the background. So finally, we have seen how you can create our dual lighting effect. So first we use the portrait image create out this effect, then after that we have used the same techniques and create out this cover design. So I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.